So she says here, فَالْوَاجِبُ عَلَيْنَا الْإِسْتِسْلَامُ لِشَرْعِ رَبِّنَا. What is incumbent, what is an obligation upon all of us, is that we submit and surrender to the legislation of our Lord. Meaning that this is a commandment from Allah Azza wa Jal. Just as Allah has commanded to make salat, He also has commanded that we should use our tongue in a special and in a proper way. Just as Allah Azza wa Jal has prohibited alcohol and eating pork, likewise He has prohibited that we backbite others and speak ill of them, or that we carry tales. So just as a believer will submit and pray like this, or he will establish the salat or establish the zakat, or just as a believer will leave off pork and will leave off alcohol, also they must leave off backbiting. This is part of the legislation of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is part of the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is incumbent upon somebody who is striving to be upon the straight path. The one who did not leave off these actions, they have fallen into major sin. And this is not from surrendering and submitting to Allah Azza wa Jal. So she says, for who will qa'il? Allah, He is the one who has said. And she's mentioning now evidences that are general evidences for the proof of the obligation of obeying Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But she's mentioning these proofs, these general proofs, because to show the importance of backbiting, and that backbiting is included in these general proofs. We know how the people of the Sunnah particularly, they take pride and they love to follow Allah and His Messenger. And they love this claim to obedience of Allah and His Messenger, and to as-salafiyya, and to be upon the methodology of the Salaf. But from the completion of that salafiyya, and from that iman, and from one's holding fast to the sunnah, and we talk about striving hard to be upon the sunnah, and being steadfast upon the sunnah, holding fast to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The sunnah is like the ship of Nuh alayhi salam. All of these narrations that we know, the obligation of obeying Allah and His Messenger, and how the people of the sunnah, they love this so much. But she's making the point here that also included in that is leaving off backbiting, which has become very easy for many people. Rather, many people have begun to enjoy that and to take pleasure in that. And this is contrary to submission and surrender. And this is contrary to holding fast to the sunnah. This is contrary to being steadfast upon the straight path. So she says, فَهُوَ الْقَائِلِ Allah Azza wa Jal, He is the one who said, وَمَا كَانَ لِلْمُؤْمِنِ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمْ خِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ وَمَا يَعْسِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا مُبِينًا. She mentioned the verse of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the meaning of which is that verily, it is not for a believing male nor a believing female if Allah and His Messenger decree or command an issue or affair, or they make a commandment, that they would have any choice in their affair. The believer, the male or female, if they hear the commandment of Allah Azza wa Jal, or the commandment of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also included in that any of the prohibition, then they will not have any choice in their affair. The believer, and this is talking about the one who has strong iman, al-mu'mina wa al-mu'mina, the strong believer and the strong believing woman. Likewise, that if they hear the commandments of Allah and His Messenger, the legislation of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they have no choice. They have no choice. They don't think twice about it. They don't think twice about it. And then Allah, He says, and whoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then verily they have erred into clear misguidance. So here's a threat. And from the disobedience of Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger is backbiting. And here Allah is mentioning here that the believers, they have no choice. If they hear a commandment from Allah and His Messenger, except that they submit. Naam, and whoever, as a threat, reminding whoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger, then they have strayed into clear misguidance. And so backbiting is disobedience to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and this is also the means to stray into clear misguidance.